Hello friends, today once again we'll try to answer another set of 5 interesting gardening questions and thoughts. Questions like, my grandma says never go near plants in night time. Can we use animal or menstrual blood on plants? Can we use human or animal urine for plants? And 2 more interesting questions coming up. If you're interested in gardening, please click on the bell icon to receive notifications on my new uploads. Now let's begin with the first question, that is the grandma question. My grandma says, do not go near plants during the night time. Why? During daytime, in the presence of sunlight, plants prepare their food. That's called photosynthesis. They take in carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, water from the roots, and then sunlight, and prepare their sugars. So, in daytime, they take up carbon dioxide and release oxygen, and that's good. But during night, they take oxygen and release carbon dioxide, and hence the air near trees will have lesser concentration of oxygen and higher concentration of carbon dioxide. That is why it is not advisable to go near trees during the night time. However, this impact will be negligible for small plants and at home gardens, and only be noticeable near very large trees or in thick vegetation. Another important point to note here is some plants even prepare food at night without the use of sunlight by a process called CAM, that is crassulation acid metabolism type of photosynthesis. I have discussed this in one of my videos titled The 24-Hour Oxygen Producing Plants for Your Health. I have linked that video in the description below. Now the next question. What is the world's largest flower? The flower with the world's largest bloom is Rafflesia arnoldi, found in the rainforests of Indonesia. It can grow to a size of about 3 feet across and can weigh up to 50 pounds. Actually, it is a parasitic plant with no visible leaves, roots or stem. Now the next question. My tomato plant is producing a lot of flowers but not fruiting. The answer to this question is really simple. The commonest reason is insufficient pollination. Check the pesticides you are using. This might be preventing honeybees and other beneficial pollinator insects from entering your garden. The other causes can be insufficient fertilizers, and in that case, consider adding a high potash and high calcium fertilizers. Well, the next interesting question is, can I add blood to plants? Can menstrual blood fertilize your plants? Well, the answer to blood is yes. But before that, let me explain this. To start, as you all know, most fertilizers are based on 3 major plant nutrients, that is nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, that is NPK. And all 3 of these elements are present in blood. Not only blood, this applies to any stuff like fish meal, bone meal or even animal blood. But here is the catch and scientific explanation. You might already know that uncomposted manure or non-decomposed manure like cow dung and stuff like that can be harmful to the plants. That is, can burn your plants. That is the reason we use decomposed manure and we make compost at home in our compost bin. When you add anything raw, including the raw smoothie what many people recommend for your plants, which they make by blending all raw kitchen waste and things like that. And I have discussed this in one of my recent videos. The problem is, its decomposition process is going to promote the growth of all sorts of microorganisms which can be harmful to the plants and can even human beings. In addition, the nitrogen is consumed by these microorganisms for decomposition process, and this will lead to nitrogen deficiency in plants, something similar to nitrogen stealing, which I have discussed in one of my videos titled Sawdust for Your Plants. So then how do I use blood? Yes, you can purchase blood meal, fish meal, bone meal and all types of these organic fertilizers from a garden store. You can use this because these are prepared from dried or decomposed animal blood. So that's it. Now the next interesting question is, can animal or human urine be used as a fertilizer? Well, this looks a little uncomfortable for most of us. But the truth is, human or animal urine, for example, cow urine contains loads of NPK, that is nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, which are the most essential plant nutrients for agricultural use. But it has to be applied in dilution of at least 1:20 in water. This topic needs more detailed discussion and concepts. We'll look into it in some other episode. So there we have it, folks. Please like, share and comment on the video. Consider subscribing if you're new to the channel. Happy gardening!